Hello learners, I am Mohini Arora, HOD Computer Science, and I welcome all the students who have taken computer science as a subject. Today we will be covering the chapter control statements, and in this chapter we will be covering about the conditional statements. I hope you enjoy the session. In this session of control statements, we will be covering about various types of statements. What is a statement? What is a compound statement? What is a null statement? Then we will be covering various conditional statements that are provided in C++, if else, if else if, nested ifs and switch case. So first and foremost, we begin with what is a statement. This is one topic that you have used while programming before also. A statement is an instruction given to the computer to perform any kind of action. For example, if you say cout 10, then that is a statement. So any instruction given to the computer in any form is a statement. Any action may be performed in the form of data movement, decision making, displaying, accepting, all these are simple statements. All statements form the smallest executable unit within a C++ program, and all statements are always terminated by a semicolon. I would like to mention here that even though you may write two different statements in two different lines, or you may write them in same line, it doesn't affect the output, because for the compiler, semicolon denotes that the statement has finished. Then the coming on to the next line or pressing the enter key has no effect on the execution of the program by the compiler. We move on to compound statements. Compound statements are the set of statements, grouping of statements in which each individual statement ends with a semicolon. That is what is a compound statement. These group of statements are known as blocks, and these are enclosed between a pair of curly brackets. You must have worked in main function, so entire main function we can say that yes, it is a compound statement. You will be also be working with other functions, user defined functions in due course. So each function is considered to be a compound statement because it is having a group of other executable statements within the set of curly brackets. The opening bracket signifies the beginning and the closing bracket signifies the end of the block. Then we move on to the next type of statement, that is the null statement. If I write only a semicolon, nothing else before it, then it is a null or an empty statement. This is useful only when the syntax of the language needs to specify a statement, but logic of the program does not need any statement. You will come across certain situations when I am using a semicolon just because the syntax needs it, although logically it holds no value. So such a statement where only a semicolon is used as a syntax requirement is known as a null statement. This statement is generally used in for and while looping statements. You will do in due course of time. And then we move on to conditional statements. As the name says, conditional means based on certain condition. The conditional statements are used when the program needs to be executed depending upon a particular condition. Say for example, I want to display the number if the number is even. I don't want to display if the number is odd. So what the compiler will do, will it display the number or will it not display the number, depends on the condition that I am checking, whether the number that is given to me is an even number or is an odd number. Various conditional statements are there in your course. We have if statement, we have if else statement, we have if else statement, nested if statement and switch statement. So all these we will be covering one by one. All these are conditional statement. All these are executed depending upon whether the condition that you are giving is true or false. So that means the output varies. Output varies if the condition is true, and output varies if the condition is false. First and foremost, we have if statement, the simplest of the conditional statements. The syntax and the flowchart both are shown here, as you can see in the flowchart. In the decision box, we give the condition. Any condition that we give can have only two results. Either that condition will be true or that condition will be false. There is no other possibility out of a condition. Say for example, I say, is the number greater than 10? Then is the number greater than 10 is a condition. The answer can be either yes or no, true or false. Yes, the number is greater than 10, or no, the number is not greater than 10. So you want a different set of statements to be executed if the number is greater than 10. And you don't want anything to be done if the number is not greater than 10. In such situations, you use the if statement. You can see the syntax, the keyword if, and it is followed by the condition in round bracket. This keyword is case sensitive. Please note, all the conditional statements are case sensitive. That means I and F have to be in small case. You cannot have I in capital or F in capital. And the condition is always enclosed in round brackets. And this condition is followed by a block. We call it if block. The statements inside the block will be executed if and only if the condition is true. Nothing will be done, no job is done by the compiler, no statement is executed if the condition is false. So, if the condition is true, statement 1 is executed, as you can see in the flowchart. Otherwise, statement 2 is executed. The statement 1 may either be a single or a compound statement. Then we have if else statement. Now, in the previous statement, the else part was not taken into consideration. Means if the condition was true, then yes, I was executing a set of statements. But if the condition is false, then I was not doing anything. Means nothing was being done by the compiler. If you see this flowchart, if you see this particular syntax, then both the conditions are being taken care of. Means I am having both the blocks. One, the if block, which will be executed if the condition is true. Then I have the else block. The statement 2 that is given in the syntax is having the else block. And I'll again repeat, statement 1 and statement 2 can be simple statements, means just one single statement to be executed, or can be compound statements, means multiple statements being executed if the condition is true. If you are having a compound statement, then those compound statements should be enclosed within a set of curly brackets. And statement 3, as it is given in the syntax, will be executed in all circumstances. Means may the condition be true or may the condition be false, statement 3 will always be executed. But statement 1 will be executed if and only if the condition is true. Statement 2 will be executed if and only if the condition is false. So, if the condition is true, statement 1 is executed followed by statement 3. Statement 3 is out of the if statement. It is a common statement. So, it will be executed in all circumstances. If the condition is false, statement 2 will be executed followed by statement 3. You have an example here. This example is printing the greatest of two numbers. That means I am accepting two numbers from the user. As the example says, the numbers are stored in variables x and y. If x is greater than y, I am saying the bigger number is x. So, if x is greater than y is the if condition according to the syntax. See out, the bigger number is x will be executed if the condition is true. That means if x is greater than y, the condition will be true. And so this particular statement will be executed. Otherwise, the else block, that means the statement the bigger number is y, will be executed. This slide also shows the output. Two numbers are entered, 10 and 15, and the larger number is 15 is displayed. Why? Because the condition 10 greater than 15 is false. So the statement following the else keyword is executed. So the bigger number is 15 is displayed as the output by the compiler. We move on to next type of conditional statement, which is the nested if statement. Nested if, as the name suggests, an if that is enclosed inside another if. That is what is a nested if. Means if I want to check for multiple conditions, I use the nested if statement. As the syntax says, first condition, if condition 1. If that is true, then I move on to if condition 2. If that is true, then the statements will be executed. Same thing is shown in the flowchart behind. I check for the condition first. If it is true, I move on to condition 2. If it is false, I move out of the if block. If condition 2 is false, then also I move out of the if block. If both the conditions are true, then a particular statement is executed. So I have enclosed the if, which in this syntax is with condition 2, inside the if, which in this example is condition 1. So the second if is nested or enclosed inside the first if. So that is why we give the name as nested if statement. Then other type of conditional statement is if else if. This is particularly used when I want to check for multiple conditions. Say for example, in this particular flowchart you are saying that one condition is there. If it is true, a particular statement is executed. If it is not true, then I want to check for something, some else condition, some other condition on the same logic principle. Say for example, I am accepting a set of marks from the students. If the marks are greater than 90, I have a particular grade, say A. If it is between 80 and 90, I have B. This will be my second condition followed by else if. If it is between 70 and 80, I have grade C. Again an else if with this particular condition. So when I am checking for multiple values of the same variable or multiple conditions of the same logic that I am moving on, then else if comes out to be very, very useful. You can have multiple else ifs along with a single if, but you can have only one else. You cannot have multiple else. This thing has to be taken care of, that any if statement can have multiple else ifs, but it should have only one else. So statement which will be executed if the condition is true, in this example is statement 1. Then next condition I am checking with else if, statement 2. If I have some other conditions, I can add more else ifs into it. And if none of the conditions are true, then it goes to the else part. And statement 3 is executed as per the example that is shown to you here. Again, there is an example, a program using nested if condition that will enter total marks and assign grade according to this particular values, greater than 90 A, between 80 and 90 B, and between 70 and 80 C, between 60 and 70 D, and otherwise it is fail. So I am having multiple values of marks to be tested, and depending upon these values, grade will be given to the student. So this particular slide shows you the program where I am having marks. This statement is accepting the marks. Then I am checking for the first condition. This is the first if marks is greater than equal to 90. What happens if the marks is greater than equal to 90? A grade is displayed. But if not greater than 90, then if marks is greater than equal to 80, that means they will lie between 80 and 90. So this is the second if, which is enclosed between the first if, though it is the nested if. If this is true, then B grade. If it is not greater than 80, that means it is less than 80. So it's less than 80, then I come between 70 to 80 range. Again, the second else and the third if comes, which checks for the marks to be greater than 70. Displays the C grade. Again, the third else comes. If it is greater than 60, this is the fourth nested if. So you can see that I have also indented the program accordingly. With every else, there's a slight tab space coming up, so that you can notice how the else comes before the if that is given above it. So if it is greater than equal to 60, then D grade. If none of the options that are given above are true, that means marks are not greater than 90, they're not greater than 80, they're not greater than equal to 70, they're not greater than equal to 60, that means they are less than 60. So none of the conditions given above were true. So it comes to the else part. So it will come to the else part if none of the conditions given in else ifs or in nested ifs are true. So fail will be displayed if marks are less than 60. So that is how this particular program shows you how to display different grades depending upon the marks entered by the student. All these different grades, these slabs are taken care of by the if statements. If statement was a very, very useful statement. It covers most of the branching conditions that we require in our course of programming. But there's another conditional statement, that is the switch statement or switch case statement, as we say. It allows me to do multiple branching in a single statement. It is very useful if I want to check a particular expression or a particular variable for multiple values, for equality with multiple values. Say for example, I want to check the day of the week to be entered. If the user enters the value of the day as 1, I display Sunday. Value of day as 2, I display Monday. So I am checking a constant value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 to be entered by the user. Depending upon what value it enters, I do the corresponding statement execution. That means if I give first value as 1, it comes in the first case. You can see the syntax coming up on the screen. The keyword is switch, followed by the variable or the expression. This expression should result in a single value. It can be an integer value, it can be a character value, it can be a float value, it can be any value, but it should be a constant value. So depending upon that value, whatever probable constant values I am expecting, those I enter into my cases. So for example, if the user enters 1 as the value of the variable, so I say case 1. And what I want to do if the user enters 1 are followed by this particular case. Case space the value followed by a colon, as is seen in your screen, followed by the statements that I want to execute if this match comes out to be true. That means if the value entered by the user is this value entered in this case, then these set of statements will be executed. If I have another value, say 2, case 2, so the statements following that particular case will be executed. Means if I say enter a particular value, user enters 2, then whatever is given in statement 2 block will be executed. Likewise, I can enter multiple values in a switch case. I can enter as many values as I want in a switch case. But if I have entered say 10 values from say 1 to 10 and the user does not enter any value out of those, means I asked him to enter numbers between 1 to 10, but he enters 15. So means none of the cases given above will match. In such situations, when none of the case matches, the control goes to the default statement. means default statement will be executed if none of the case values given above match. So generally in default statement we give error messages that you have entered a wrong number, or we give some messages like try again, where the user should do the entire process again because none of the values have matched whatever cases were given in the program. Another thing peculiar about this switch case statement, you must be seeing on the screen, there's a break statement after every switch case. So this break statement means that when a case has matched and the corresponding compound statements have been executed or the statement block has been executed, then the control must go out of the switch case. I have got a matching case. I have got the statements that I wanted to be executed. If that particular case matched, then I should not be executing, I should not be compiling more statements in that particular switch case. So the control moves out of the switch case the moment break statement is encountered. I'll also like to notify that giving break or giving default is not compulsory in a switch case. It totally depends on your logic, what logic you want to use. Accordingly, you may even skip it. So, if you remove break, if you remove default, then it will not give you a syntax error. But yes, logically the program might go wrong if it is not giving a proper output. So, let's understand the working of a switch statement. The execution begins with the evaluation of the expression, whatever expression you have given inside after the switch in round brackets. That particular expression will be evaluated, or you may also give a variable whose values will be evaluated. If the values of the expression matches with the constant that the statements following the expression will be executed, these constants are given after each case, say case 1. Case 2, case 3 and so on. So, till the time break statement is not encountered, it will keep on executing all the statements. The break statement transfers the control to the end of the switch case statement, means it skips everything in between. Say if case 1 comes out to be true, it will execute all the statements following the case 1. The moment break is encountered, it will leave out all other statements that are there in switch case. The control immediately moves out of the switch case. If the value of expression does not match with any constant, then obviously the default statement is executed. So this is the flow chart that explains the working of the switch case statement. You have first the evaluation of the expression. Then it checks if the value is equal to the constant. This is the statement where I give the case. Case is again a keyword. All small letters are used in switch and in case. Case space followed by the value. So it is checking if the value is equal to constant. If it is true, then the statements following that case will be executed. If it is false, it checks for the next case value. Similarly, if that next case value is true, statement 2 is executed, otherwise it moves on to the next case. If there is no other case, it moves to the default. So it executes the statements that is given in the default and the control moves out of the switch case. It's a very, very useful statement in situations where I am checking multiple constant values for a single variable or an expression. Is an example of a switch case statement. I have a char variable. I ask the user to enter a character and then I check. This is the switch statement. You can see that it is all in small case and the variable that I want to check is given in round bracket. Since it is a compound statement, so opening bracket. First case, it checks for A. A constant value A is checked whether the user has entered A in CH. If it is true, then it displays the message vowel A and breaks. That means once the user enters A, output will be vowel A nth control moves out of the switch statement. No further statements inside the switch case will be executed the moment break is encountered. Next case E, again it displays vowel E and then breaks out. So if the user enters E, case A will not be matched, it will skip the statements. Case E matches, it displays and then breaks out. Similarly for O, I, U and default, that means if the user enters anything other than A, E, I, O, U in small, user will enter, not the computer will display the message as not a vowel, right? And this ends the switch case statement. So this particular program is accepting a character from the user and displaying a message if it is a vowel, and displaying a message not a vowel if it is not a vowel. So any of the cases, if they match, that particular statement will be executed and it will move out of the switch case statement because break is given. If break is not given, then it will execute all the statements following that particular case till the time either break is encountered or the closing bracket, curly bracket is encountered. So with switch case, we come to the end of this session. In this session, we differentiated between statements and compound statements, and we also gave a hint on null statement. We also studied various conditional statements and their use, about if else, if else ifs and switch case. I hope you will use these statements to make your programs, to understand conditions in your program and to display various outputs based on conditions in your programs. Thank you.